I did not hit her. It's not true. It's bullshit. I did not hit her. I did not. Oh, hi, Mark. Oh, hey, Johnny, what's up? I have a problem with Lisa. She says that I hit her. What?
Well, did you?
No, it's not true. Don't even ask. What's new with you?
Well, I'm just sitting up here thinking, you know? I got a question for you.
Yeah.
Do you think girls like to cheat like guys do?
What makes you say that?
I don't know. Just thinking.
I don't have to worry about that because Lisa's loyal to me.
You never know. People are very strange these days. I once knew a girl that had a dozen guys. One of them found out about it, beat him up so bad that he ended up at a hospital on Guerrero Street.
What a story, Mark.
End of Act 1. Intermission.
Alright guys, here we are. You must be wondering, why am I in here? Why am I not in my cool, like, area with the backgrounds and the Star Wars and the posters and all that? Well, it's because I'm gonna do a very special video today. This is something I've never done before. I am going to go through the entirety of the room. I have not seen it, but Disaster Artist is coming out in not long from now. It's gonna come out, I think, December 1st. I don't know if it's gonna have limited releases or anything, but nonetheless, The Disaster Artist is going to be coming out, which is obviously a movie about the making of The Room. It's about Tommy Wiseau and Greg, I forget his last name, but it is a movie about the creation of The Room, and it's by James Franco. And to celebrate that, I wanted to watch one of the best movies ever made, The Room.
Yeah, you can say that again.
The movie that The Disaster Artist is based on. I'm going to watch this movie all the way through, because believe it or not, I've only seen segments from The Room. I haven't seen the entire thing all the way through. So this is going to be a new experience for me. I'm going to watch the whole thing. And it's going to be an enlightening experience because, like you know, The Room was regarded as one of the best movies ever made. So let's see what I think of this movie. Alright guys, let's do this. I have a feeling I might need this. So we open up on a bunch of random shots of places. I believe Tommy Wiseau is listed like 10 times at least. Take a shot every time he comes up in the opening credits and you'll get pretty hammered, trust me. We then have our opening scene which establishes the romantic chemistry between these actors, and you'll soon notice that none of them can act at all.
Hi, babe. I have something for you.
Oh, hi, babe. I have something for you. What a great start.
What is it?
Just a little something.
I love how Tommy Wiseau thinks he's like the super attractive, likable guy and he can get with an attractive girl like that. This guy is more deluded than that guy on American Idol years ago, Ian Bernardo. Anyone remember him?
Mixture of Gene Kelly, Fred Astaire, and Janet Jackson. I'm a little bit better than Janet Jackson, but I mean, I think I'm up there with Gene Kelly, because I think me and him are on par. Because I'm the number one in anything I do. Because number one is the best, number two is first loser, and I'm not gonna be a loser. When America sees this, they're gonna forget about Taylor Who, Carrie Underwear, I mean, Fantasia Wen, but they will remember Ian Bernardo. I'm here to be the next American Idol. I thought that it would be a nice addition to my already long and impressive resume.
Which is,
careful not to show it. You really don't remember. Was it something that he said or the voices in your head calling?
It's just rubbish.
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 That's British for garbage. Like, what is that? Like, rubbish. Who says that word?
You know,
even?
Ian,
no,
you're,
I don't
know.
Who
doing
said
a
that
shtick.
Word?
Do it outside.
Who are you?
Wow, you look so sexy, Lisa.
Isn't it fabulous?
I would do anything for my girl.
Oh, hey, guys.
Oh, hi, Denny.
We then get introduced to the character Denny, who's literally only in the movie to be a really creepy pervert. No, really. That's his only purpose in the entire movie.
Anything for my princess.
What other purpose could he possibly have to the rest of the movie? He hangs out with Johnny and Lisa and wants to watch them have sex. And then he does some drugs later on and gets in trouble with a drug dealer guy. That's all he does in the entire movie. Oh yeah, and that drug thing I'm talking about? Yes, that actually happens. I'm not making that up.
Nice to see you, Danny. I'm going to take a nap.
Nice to see you, Danny. I'm going to take a nap.
Oh my goodness, that ADR is fantastic. Some of the best I've ever seen in a movie. It's crazy how you can just, like, you can ADR lines later on and make it look so real, you know? It's crazy. It blows my mind. Filmmaking is crazy. So Johnny and Lisa go upstairs and it's implied that they're about to have sex. But then they just sit there fighting with pillows. And then Denny tries to watch them have sex. What's the point of this, you may ask? I haven't the slightest clue. Don't ask me. Don't ask me what the point of any scene is, because I won't be able to tell you. After they get Denny to leave, they decide to have a really slow, awkward sex montage. They're slowly taking off clothes, they're kissing, Lisa puts her hair down, only to put it back up in the next shot. It's really riveting stuff. Great filmmaking on display here. It doesn't make me want to throw up at all. They then go to the next day where Lisa's mom visits.
Hi, Mom. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you? Okay, let's go to the couch. And we will sit down. Now, what's happening with you?
What's happening with her? Where'd this come from?
What's wrong? Tell me.
I'm not feeling good today.
Why not?
I don't love him anymore.
Why don't you love him anymore? Tell me.
You don't love him anymore. But they just had sex the night before, and from what the filmmaking displayed, it seemed like they really enjoyed it.
Oh, Lisa, you know. Okay.
Holy crap, I'm literally 11 minutes into this movie, and nothing makes sense yet. It's like a new record.
He supports you. He provides for you. And darling, you can't support yourself. He's a wonderful man, and he loves you very much. And his position is very secure.
Wow. Tommy definitely doesn't like praising himself in this script. What a humble guy. I bet later in the movie he's gonna end up dying and then rise himself from the dead the next day like Jesus. Because that doesn't happen in movies ever. There's no Jesus symbolism in movies at all, ever in life. We then finally get introduced to the character Mark, and if you didn't already know, the actor plays him is the person who wrote the book The Disaster Artist that's being made into a movie right now, which is why I'm making this video. And it's easy to see that he really wants to be there in this scene. You could tell it when you look at his acting performance.
Okay. Alright, how about noon?
Okay, how about noon?
So Mark comes over to Lisa's house, and she's acting a little strange.
I mean, the candles, the music, the sexy dress, I mean, what's going on here?
What's going on here? She called you baby on the phone, acting like she wanted to see you really bad. She invites you over, starts taking off clothes, and then you ask what's going on? What?
I like you very much. Lover boy.
What are you doing this for?
What are you doing this for? She wants to have sex with you. Why are you asking questions now if it was obvious from the beginning? What? So he tries to refuse her sexual seduction by telling her that Johnny is his best friend and that he shouldn't be cheating on him, only for him to just abruptly give in anyway. Wow, this is fantastic writing. I want to meet the guy who wrote this. And then there's another fantastic, riveting montage of making love on the stairs. Interesting location. You know what, let's just fast forward this one. My gosh, just the scene. The holy grail of bad scenes. Yes! Yes, I can't wait to see this scene!
Hi.
Can I help you?
Yeah, can I have a dozen red roses, please?
Oh, hi, Johnny. I didn't know it was you. Here you go.
That's me. How much is it?
It'll be $18.
Here you go. Keep the change. Hi, doggy.
You're my favorite customer.
Thanks a lot. Bye.
It's so beautiful. I don't even need to explain it. But I'm going to anyway. I love how throughout this scene, nobody's mouth moves. Tommy's mouth doesn't move. The clerk's mouth doesn't move. Nothing really flows. Also.
Oh, hi, Johnny. I didn't know it was you.
Hi, Johnny. I didn't know it was you. Who else looks like that? And why did she say,
here you go.
And then he says,
that's me.
What sense does that make? Why does he need to say that? The reason this scene is so famous is because it's literally 30 seconds long, and there's so much wrong with those 30 seconds. It's pretty incredible, actually. We then cut back to Lisa at her house as Daddy visits her again.
What's new?
Actually, I'm really busy. Do you want something to drink?
No, thanks. I just want to talk to Johnny. You look beautiful today. Can I kiss you?
What?
Did you get your promotion?
Nah.
You didn't get it, did you?
What part about nah did you not understand?
But son of a bitch told me that I would get it within 3 months. I saved them bundles. They're crazy. I don't think I will ever get it.
Good. Great. Good.
I'm tired. I'm wasted. I love you, darling.
Come on, make love to me.
Are you serious?
Again? You know, I've seen many scenes from this movie, but I didn't realize there was so much sex in it. Was Wiseau trying to make a drama or a porno? I don't really get what the goal here was.
15 years ago, we agreed that house belongs to me. Now the value of the house is going up and he's seeing dollar signs. Everything goes wrong at once. Nobody wants to help me, and I'm dying.
What? She's dying? Where did this come from?
I got the results of the test back. I definitely have breast cancer.
She has breast cancer? Jeez!
Look, don't worry about it. Everything will be fine.
Don't worry about it? Everything will be fine? They're both taking this remarkably well.
Well, at least you have a good man.
You're wrong. Mom, he's not what you think he is. He didn't get his promotion. And he got drunk last night. And he hit me.
Johnny doesn't drink.
Okay, she hears that Johnny hit her, and all she has to say is, Johnny doesn't drink! No wonder Lisa hates her mom. She doesn't give a crap about her own daughter. We then see these two random people go into Lisa's house, and they start having a bit of fun. How many sex scenes are we at now? Oh, is this the fourth one? That's a lot of valuable screen time. We then cut to a random shot of the outside, only to cut right back to the inside of the house, where Lisa and her mom find these two individuals that invaded their home. All you audience watching this video right now for some reason like my videos, you may be wondering, hey Nate, hey the guy that runs Stupid Beagle Reviews, what is the point of this scene? Well, I would answer to you that there is no point. It never comes up again. I think Tommy Wiseau was just very horny while making this movie and wanted to make a bunch of sex scenes, but that's just a guess. I'm not sure if that's correct. We then cut to Denny on top of a roof when someone comes to pay him a visit. Wow, that green screen is fantastic. Totally not noticeable at all. That great job you got there. It's almost as good as Justice League.
Where's my money?
Okay, just give me 5 minutes. Just give me five.
5 minutes? Where's my money, Denny?
Where's my f***ing money, Denny? Just use my f***ing money!
I swear to God, it's coming!
Where's my f***ing money, Denny?
Hey, excuse me. Those are bad words. I don't appreciate your potty mouth language. This is a PG channel. I don't... There's no bad words on this channel ever, you little... And the beep and the censor stuff.
What's going on? Somebody help!
Let's take him to the train.
Fucking dead!
Tell me everything.
You have no idea what kind of trouble.
Why did you do this? You know better, right? Why?
Good. Got it. Great. Good.
Denny, you know that Johnny's like your father. And we're your friends. We're gonna help you.
Let's go home.
My friends, this has been another pointless moment! We then have a conversation between Tommy and Mark on top of the roof, which is the most iconic scene in the movie.
Did not hit her. It's not true. It's bullshit. I did not hit her. I did not. Oh, hi, Mark.
Get it!
I used to know a girl. She had a dozen guys. One of them found out about it, beat her up so bad she ended up in a hospital on Guerrero Street.
What a story, Mark.
What a story, Mark. What's so funny about that? I failed to see what's so funny about that moment. I don't understand. Nate, calm down. It's only a stupid movie. Happy thoughts.
Ha! Gotta tell you about something.
Shoot, Danny.
It's about Lisa.
Go on.
She's beautiful. She looks great in a red dress. I think I'm in love with her.
Go on.
Go on? Sounds like he's heard enough.
Sometimes when I'm around her, I feel like I want to kiss her and tell her that I love her. I don't know. I'm just confused.
Danny, don't worry about that. Lisa loves you too, as a person, as a human being, as a friend. You know, people don't have to say it. They can feel it. If a lot of people love each other, the world would be a better place to live.
Lisa's your future wife.
Can you just say fiance? Oh wait, yeah. I forgot that Tommy Wiseau doesn't know what the word fiance means.
You must be kidding, aren't you?
Look, I don't want to talk about it. I'm going to go upstairs and wash up and go to bed.
How dare you talk to me like that? You should tell me everything.
I can't talk right now.
Why, Lisa? Please talk to me, please. You're part of my life. You're everything.
You are tearing me apart, Lisa.
So then we have a scene where Tommy plays catch with his buddies. Because I guess that's what he thinks people do when they talk to each other. They throw the football around. That's a thing.
He doesn't.
Hey, Jenny, what's
hey,
up?
Hey, what's up, Mark?
Well, hi, Mark.
Catch it.
What's going on, man? Too much? What are you guys?
He just telling us about an underwear issue.
Dude, don't worry.
Underwear?
Dude, it's...
underwear.
It's embarrassing, man. I don't want to get into it.
Underwear, man? Come on.
Are you okay?
Are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine. Are you okay?
Sure?
Uh-huh.
Alright.
Come see the doctor.
No,
I'm tough. This has been another pointless moment. Lisa and her mom decide to talk, again, about the same stuff, right in the open.
I expected your husband to be a little more generous.
He's not my husband.
I know, but Johnny is part of our family.
Mom, I don't love Johnny anymore.
Oh.
I don't even like him.
They've had this conversation like 5 times in the movie already. Johnny's a good man. I don't like Johnny. Why don't you like Johnny? Blah, blah, blah. It's like Tommy Wiseau thinks his audience, whoever those are, won't get it the first 100 times.
Hi, Mark. Come in.
Oh, hey, Johnny. Hey, Peter.
We're just talking about women.
Women, man. Women just confuse me. I have a girl. She's married. I mean, she's very attractive. It's driving me crazy.
Why didn't you mention this before? I mean, is there anyone I know?
Nah, man, you don't know her.
Can I meet her?
Why? Why in the living hell would you bring that up in front of Tommy Wiseau, who's right there, his best friend, he's engaged to the person you're sleeping with? Why would you do that?
I am, sure.
No, I'm not doing it this year.
Chicken, Peter, you just a little chicken.
Cheep, 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 cheep.
Who are you calling a chicken? I just don't like all the weirdos. There's too many weirdos there.
Mark and Tommy then decide to go talk about girls being difficult again. You know, one of the things I've noticed while watching this movie is that it's so repetitive. Like, they literally have the same conversations over and over and over again. It's actually pretty incredible.
What's going on here?
I like you very much, Mark.
Oh, come on, Johnny's my best friend.
You gotta be kidding me. See what I mean about it being repetitive? They've had sex how many times now and he's still surprised? What?
We have plenty of time. All I have to do is put on my party dress. Come on.
Wait, what are you doing?
Nothing.
One hour later.
You know what? Screw it. I'm fast forwarding this. Something happens that's different and not the same thing! Yes! Oh my goodness!
Okay, thanks a lot again. Thank you.
Thanks. Can I drink this one? Yeah, later.
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 Yes.
What was that? Was that a video game loading screen?
Hey everybody, let's go outside for some fresh air. Wait. I have something I want to show you.
Oh, really?
What's going on here?
Oh no, they caught us. What the hell did you think was gonna happen? Oh, boo-hoo!
Hey, everybody. I have an announcement to make. We're expecting.
Oh my God!
I love that reaction. Everyone just like, yay! Whoa, yay, that's good.
You're my future wife. What are you doing, Lisa?
Leave her alone, man. She doesn't want to talk to you.
Since when do you give me orders?
Lisa changed her mind about you.
Huh. Wake up, man. What planet are you on?
I don't know, but it's probably somewhere really far away. Like, really far. really freaking far.
Get out of my house. I kill you, I bring him in
full
of
hey, money. Stop it!
I kill you, you bastard.
Yeah, because that's how fighting works.
You can come out now, Johnny. She's gone.
In a few minutes, bitch.
I need to talk to you.
What's going on?
Don't worry about Johnny. He's just being a big baby. You know, I love you very much.
He's right there in the other room! What are you doing?
Who are you talking to?
Nobody.
We'll see about that. We'll see about that.
It's all the way downstairs. How did it record that in perfect quality? And how come you can hear Mark's voice as clear as Lisa's when he's on the other line of the phone? And why did Johnny say, "We'll see about that," twice?
We'll see about that. We'll see about that.
How could you do this to me? I gave you 7 years of my life.
And you betray me. We'll see what else we have in this state.
No. Stop. You little prick, I put up with you for 7 years. You think you're an angel. You're just like everybody.
No, he really isn't. So Lisa officially leaves Johnny for Mark, and he has a bit of a temper tantrum.
Why, Lisa? Why, bitch?
Why is this happening to me? Why?
It's over.
God, forgive me.
Everything will be all right. Good night, Johnny.
Okay, so suicide is something I take very seriously. It is a problem that's been something throughout our society that's been a problem for a long time. People have gone through it. A lot of young people have taken their lives at a really early age. It's a very tragic thing that happens in our society, and I wish it would come to a stop, and I wish it didn't have to happen anymore. I wish people would seek help more often. But this movie succeeded in making a suicide funny. They made a suicide funny in a movie. Tommy Wiseau, you have gained a new real world record of making a suicide funny. You should be in the Guinness Book of World Records for that. You really should, man.
Wake up, Johnny, come on!
Wake up, Johnny, come on?
Is he dead?
Is he dead? He shot himself in the mouth and he's bleeding all over! What do you mean, is he dead? Look at him! He's deceased! Look at his...
What's happening?
Don't look, Denny.
Johnny's dead! Wake up, Johnny, please! Please, it's not right!
Are you kidding me? Does that not look dead to you? What is this about this image that doesn't look dead to them? Okay, so that was The Room. That was the movie that is considered by many to be one of the worst things that's ever made. But it's also, like, it's so bad that it's really enjoyable to watch. I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys. When I watched this movie, I was having a blast from start to finish. This movie is one of those movies that is so unintentionally bad that it is so entertaining to watch. And it's so intriguing to see what's gonna happen next. And so it's so intriguing to know what went behind the scenes to this movie. Why is there so many spoons all over the place? Why is there so many script errors? Why is everything so incredibly bad, like worse than any movie? Why is it like that? This is one of the reasons I'm looking so forward to The Disaster Artist in December, is because there's so much intriguing stuff about what happened behind the scenes of this movie, and how it got made, and how this actually happened. I want to see more into this project. I want to understand how things were so incredibly terrible in this movie. Which is why I made this video, because I'm absolutely looking forward to The Disaster Artist, and I recommend you watch The Room, because it is an experience. I've seen many scenes from it before I watched it all the way through, and I really recommend watching the whole thing, because it's a new experience that I had never really fully experienced before. And with that,
can't find it. It's probably under my bed. I don't want to go under there. With all the skeletons under there, ugh. That thing is ruined. It wasn't even a cool one anyways. It's not like it was an Emoji Movie fidget spinner. Now that's a good fidget spinner. I mean, I can't look dank in front of the other kids at school now, but it's not like I look that dank because I didn't have Sir Patrick Stewart's excellent poop emoji character on my fidget spinner, so I guess my life's not that much over. Still have my glow-up Skechers. There's a plus there.